So today I want to talk to you about Dutch test results for males that I find five major areas along the Dutch test that a lot of males are missing out on that their practitioners aren't telling them. And I get a lot of inquiries as to, hey, I had a Dutch test, my doctor didn't really give me lots of information, and I'm still suffering with fill in the blank. And that could be libido issues, that could be emotional, crying a little bit more, that could also be lack of motivation and drive, not handling stress very well, crashing in the middle of the day, not having energy to exercise, your rhythm is off, so you're more energetic at night, you're less energetic in the morning, and ultimately you just aren't doing well. My name is Dr. Joel Rosen, and I help people recover from an exhaustion and burnout nightmare. And I want to talk to you about the Dutch test. So the Dutch test stands for a dried urinary total cortisol and hormone test. And it's a really awesome test. And I do it every single day with my clients. And I find these are the five things that most guys miss out on that they're not being told about. And sometimes when you get more information, it can be the difference for you getting your energy back and your libido back and your motivation back and your drive back. So first thing I want to talk to you about is that HPA axis dysfunction. So HPA axis dysfunction, the brain signals to the adrenals and the adrenals make cortisol and they make mineral corticoids or glucocorticoids, even your sex hormones in DHEA. And over time, when your body's been under stress, whether it's psychosocial, physical, emotional, environmental, all of the above, that HPA axis starts to become dysregulated. So one of the ways we look at that is looking at the total metabolized cortisol. And we look at that in relationship to the free fraction of the cortisol. And we can tell if the dials are turned up all the way, it's an upregulation. If the dials are turned down all the way, it's a down regulation. But that's not happening at the adrenal level, that's happening at the brain level. So you need to understand that it's happening at the brain level. Got to ask yourself, why is the central command station telling the adrenals to speed up or slow down? So it gives us some indication of how long it's been going on and what your body's doing to compensate. Some of the things that I see is we look at the ratio of that central command in terms of how much cortisol you're spilling out compared to the free fraction of the hormone. I tell people the free fraction is the amount that's available for spending in your wallet that may not be utilized or being available to be spent. And there's a lot of reasons for that. But suffice to say, we look at the ratio of how much available spending money do you have in comparison to the metabolized cortisol and how much have you produced for the day. When we look at those two ratios, we can understand, is this a hypothyroid challenge? Is this an increased clearance? Is this a decreased clearance? Are they ratios looking the same? Are they high? Are they low? And we can make changes based on that. But that's from the brain level. I want to explain that. So keep that in mind. That's from the brain level. The other thing I'll look for, guys, is how much testosterone are you producing? Is it going down the alpha pathway? Is it going down the beta pathway? Interestingly, for different people, it can go down one pathway or the other on the same reason. So for example, if I have inflammation, if I have a lot of stress, if I have chemical exposures or heavy metals or toxins, it may upregulate my 5-alpha and I'll produce more androgenic hormones, which could make male pattern balding, could make more prostate issues, or it may go down the beta pathway, which is more decrease in libido and decrease in your ability for motivation and drive. And it's really interesting because no two people are the same, but the same reason that they're experiencing fatigue and exhaustion would be the same reason that it, with different reasons, it's going down the beta or the alpha pathway. Suffice it to say, you want to look at, is testosterone low? Is it high? Is it aromatizing? Is it going down the beta pathway? Is it going down the alpha pathway? When you look at the first thing and the second thing together, now you're getting way more information. The third thing I see is liver detox. Are you aromatizing? Are you converting your testosterone into estrogen? Is if it's going down the estrogen pathway, is it going down correctly? Are you doing phase one optimally? Is it going down the 2-OH pathway or the 4-OH pathway or the 16-OH pathway? If it's going down the 2-OH pathway, great. If it's going down the 4-OH pathway, not so great. Is there a lot of estrogen? Is there a little estrogen? How is it looking? And phase two is more methylation based. That's where we look at your genetics. But if your phase one is very quick and your phase two is very low, then estrogen blockers aren't necessarily going to fix that. You want to lower the inflammation, but you want to support your detoxification. I see that happen a lot. The fourth thing I want to talk about is the 11-beta-HSD. That's basically at the cellular level. That's why I put in here, actually I meant to put in there peripheral. So whereas this tells us about the central challenges, this tells us about the peripheral challenges, meaning does the cell want more cortisol? If it does, it's going to prefer cortisol, and 11-beta-HSD is going to favor cortisol. If it favors more cortisone, 11-beta-HSD is going to be downregulated. And that gives us a lot of information, like why is your HPA axis increasing, but at the cellular level, it's decreasing. There's a discommunication going on there, and I'm sure your practitioner has not talked to you about that. And if they haven't, then reach out to me so I can support you in giving you a better interpretation. And then the last thing that I really look for is something in terms of the organic acid markers that's on the Dutch complete test, where it tells you about your B12, your B6, your dopamine, your adrenaline, your melatonin, and if you're producing DNA damage. And all of those together can be really, really insightful. So if you haven't had someone give you a proper interpretation of your Dutch test, and you're a male and you're exhausted, you're burnt out, you can't focus, you have no drive, you have no libido, and you're just focusing on adrenal support like aromatase inhibitors, or you're looking at extra testosterone and you're not solving the mystery, reach out to me because I can help you in your recovery. I hope this has been really helpful for you, and I look forward to ending your exhaustion and fatigue nightmare. Take care.